Hello, this is the final part of our training. If you're coped with the previous three, this one will seem easy to you. If you're doing well, why don't you like this video and subscribe to my channel, so you don't miss the next videos about Rubik's Cube and other puzzles. The task of this stage is, without destroying anything on the cube, to make all the parts fall into place. To such a state. We will work again with the upper side, but we need to look not from the top, because everything is solved on the top, but from the sides. The position of these details is interesting to us. And for this, you need to study two more algorithms. Let's start. With the first algorithm, you can correctly put all corners. Let me remind you that corners are these parts, and so far we focus only on them. What is the difference between correct corners and incorrect at this stage? Let's just look at the cube and at the corners. For example, this corner will be considered correct, because it stands in its place and each part is coincides with its color with the neighboring one. This corner will also be considered correct, because yellow, red and green coincide with their centers. But these two corners, which have blue, red and blue, orange, are wrong, because they don't match with their centers. If you think logically, then all that needs to be done at this stage is to swap these two corners. For this, we use the following algorithm, which is called J-permulation. I assure you, it's not as complicated as its name. Okay, let's give it a try. So, take a cube in your hands and let's try to swap these corners. I have these two corners and you have these two same corners on your cube. To do this, repeat after me. Right side clockwise, top side double turn clockwise, right side counterclockwise. Then the upper side counterclockwise, the right side clockwise, and again the double turn of the upper side. Next we use our left hand. Turn the left side counterclockwise, the upper side clockwise, the right side counterclockwise, upper side counterclockwise, and left side clockwise. And as you can see, this algorithm has swept these two corners. I understand that so far it sounds difficult, but I'm sure that right now you will be able to master this algorithm. I want to tell you how I memorized these motions when I first learned J-perm algorithm. I will try to explain. Repeat after me. At first, it's like I'm doing a regular sexy move, but not with one turn of the top side, but with two. Then we come to this case. Now I see such a square of yellow and an extra detail in it. And it just needs to be cut off with this block, as if I cut it off, put it there. Now we make a double turn. And again we get some kind of square and like something extra. Now we cut off this extra on the left side. Great, we got a correct square. Next, I'm going to combine this white part over here with this block. And I'm going to turn around the top side. And now, in one move, I'm kind of putting this whole bar down. And all that is left is to connect the same bar to the left and put it down. And the algorithm looks like this. Now that you've learned J-perm, let's learn how to use it properly. As you remember, J-perm works with corners. It swaps them. But the situations can be different. Now we are looking exclusively at corners. As you can see, if we make a few turns, we can put our corners in place. And if we have four such corners, then you will not need this algorithm. But you have at least two corners to coincide. For example, this one doesn't coincide. This one doesn't coincide. But these two, they stand in the places. So our task is to swap these corners. This is the first case. And the second is the same, but as you can see, we have two diagonal corners coinciding. That is, this one stands in its place, this one in its place, and we need to swap two diagonal corners. In the first and in the second case, J-perm is used. But here we do J-perm one time and there twice. No matter where we have these corners, just do J-perm. And now, if you look closely, we have in any case two neighboring corners coincide. One will stand still, neighboring, and these two need to be swept. And this is what ordinary J-perm does. So in the second case, we have to do J-perm twice. Do J-perm a second time. And we have all the corners standing in the places. So to sum up, if we have everything standing in place, J-perm will not be needed. If we have two parts that we need to change this way, we do one J-perm. And if we need to change this situation, we do two J-perms. After using this algorithm, as you can see, we have this situation. Everything looks almost assembled, but now we need to work with edges. And the edges are here. And here we need to learn another, a bit easier algorithm called U-perm. Yes, I know they have weird names, but it doesn't matter. Let's study U-perm right now. So, take your Rubik's cube either side, no matter where you have the parts now. We will study it right now. Repeat after me. Turn a right side twice. Upper face clockwise. Right clockwise. Upper clockwise. Right counterclockwise. Upper counterclockwise. Right counterclockwise. Upper counterclockwise. Right counterclockwise. Upper clockwise. Right counterclockwise. Now let me explain how I memorized this algorithm when I first studied it, to make it easier for you. Repeat after me. First, we just turn the right side, and then repeat. Upper, right, upper, right, and turn back, right, counter, upper, counter, right, counter, upper, counter. And again, the right goes counterclockwise. Next, we need to combine this white in one bar and put at the bottom. That's it. This is how you can easily remember this algorithm. And now let's look at how this algorithm works. U-perm is the movement of three parts one by one along a triangular direction. We will move the edges, because U-perm is working with edges. This edge goes to the adjacent side, this one also to the adjacent, and this goes in place of the first edge. That is, U-perm makes these edges move clockwise. Notice, it will not touch our back edge. So, if you see a fully assembled face in front of you, you need to turn it like this and boldly do a U-perm. Repeat after me. A cube is solved, but that's not all. Now that you've learned U-perm, you know how it works, let's learn how to use it in different cases. The first case, as always, is a situation where we don't need to do anything. We have already solved a cube, that's great, but we will take a look at other cases. So we have this case where one block at the back is assembled, and these edges, red will go to the red side, blue to the blue, green to the green. That is, you need to once move all these three parts clockwise. So, in this case, we need just one U-perm. A cube is solved. There is also such a case, very similar. At the back we have everything solved, but here are three parts that need to be swapped. But look, in this case they have to change counterclockwise. In this situation we have to do not one, but two U-perms. We have now come to the previous situation and it is solved by another U-perm. We do it. A cube is solved. Or we may have a situation where we have no assembled block on either side. Then we just make our U-perm from either side. And then we have a situation with assembled block and three parts that need to be moved clockwise. Green to green, red to red, orange to orange. Here we need one more U-perm. And the last situation seems to be the same, but there may be some differences. When we make U-perm here from either side, we will have the same story. But it will be necessary to move these parts not clockwise, but counterclockwise. So in this case we perform not one U-perm, but two. That's it. As you can see, one algorithm can cope with these four different cases. But that's not all. It may be that you don't solve Rubik's Cube because of such an unfortunate situation. This occurs if your cube was either mechanically disassembled and then you tried to assemble it in parts, or you accidentally turned over the corner. There is no solution to such situation using algorithms. So, in such a situation, you need to fix it physically by simply turning the corner with your hands or changing the position of the edge. To do it, you need to disassemble a cube and insert the edge correctly. And only then you can solve your Rubik's Cube using algorithms. By the way, if you are now holding a solved Rubik's Cube in your hands, I sincerely congratulate you. And if you don't understand something from this tutorial, you can watch this video at any time from either stage. For your convenience, there are time codes in the description. So, folks, I urge you to practice, learn these algorithms and solve Rubik's Cube by yourself. And the best way to thank me for this tutorial is to become my sponsor. I will be very grateful. Hit the like button, write a comment and watch other videos on my channel. That was CUBASTIC, thank you all so much for watching, bye everyone and have a good time!